Good morning everyone. This video is for the students of class 11th subject economics. In this video we are going to read our chapter number 12, that is forms of market, and this is our lecture number 2. So in our lecture number 1 we have read about perfect competition market. Okay, in that lecture I told you that there are 4 kinds of market: perfect competition market, monopoly market, monopolistic market and oligopoly market. So perfect competition market we have read. Okay, so monopoly and monopolistic competition market are not in your syllabus, they are deleted. So in this lecture we are going to read about oligopoly market. So what do you know by oligopoly market? See, it is form of the market in which there are few big firms and large number of buyers of a commodity. Okay, so in this kind of market there are few big firms, okay, and large number of buyers of that commodity. There are branded firms. Okay, in such kind of market, price and output decision of one firm significantly impacts the price and output decision of the rival firm in the market. Okay, so what happens if one firm changes the price and output, then it will significantly impact the other firm also. Okay, so we can say that in such kind of market, all the firms, few firms are interdependent. For example, let us take the example of Toyota, Ford, Audi, BMW. These are the important branded firms of auto market. Suppose price and output of Toyota changes. Okay, now if price and output decision of Toyota changes, then it will automatically affect the price and output relation of Audi and BMW. Okay, so we can say that in such kind of market, the decision of one firm will impact the decisions of other firms. Okay, now the features of such kind of market are small number of big firms. In such kind of market there are small number of big firms and large number of buyers. Okay, because of which a firm enjoys partial control over the price through brand loyalty. Okay, means they can control the price, but they cannot control the full, they cannot have full control over the price. Okay, so in such kind of market, full control over the price is not possible as the competitors in the market. Okay, as there are competitors in the market, so that is why only one firm cannot have full control over the price. Okay, the next feature is high degree of interdependence. It means that in such kind of market, all the firms are interrelated, they are interdependent. If the one firm changes the price and output decisions, then it will automatically affect the decisions of the other firm. Okay, so the market share of each firm is so significant that its price and output policy leaves a significant impact on price and output policy of the rival firms. Now, price and output behavior of one firm often leads to reaction by other firms in the market. Okay, now what does it mean? It means that suppose there is a producer, okay, a firm, he may not be willing to raise the price of the product, okay, fearing that rival firm may not raise it and the buyers would shift to the rival firm, because if he will lower the price of its firm, then rival firm can raise the price. Okay, now suppose a firm lowers the price and rival firms do not change the price, then he can attract, that firm can attract the buyers. Okay, but suppose if a firm is not willing to lower the price of its product, fearing that rival firms might lower it. Okay, the firm is lowering the price, rival firm also lowers the price, then it will not affect it. Okay, the buyers will shift to the rival firm because they are lowering more. Okay, so that is why in such kind of market there is high degree of interdependence. The next feature is that it is very difficult to trace firms' demand curve in such kind of market. How? See, as there is high degree of interdependence, okay, we know that in such kind of market there is higher dependence, interdependence among the competing firms. Suppose one firm lowers its price, okay, then its demand for its product may not increase. Why? Because rival firm may lower the price more. Okay, one firm is lowering its price, then its rival firm has lowered the price more. Then due to it, the consumers will shift to the rival firm and the demand for the firm's product will not increase. Okay, as rival firms may lower price more and buyers shift to rival firms. Okay, so we cannot depict what will be the firm's demand curve under oligopoly market. because there is high degree of interdependence among the competing firms. The next feature is formation of cartels. Okay, formation of cartels means what are cartels? A cartel is formal agreement among firms to avoid competition. Okay, means in such kind of market there are few firms. So few firms can form an agreement. They can enter into an agreement so that they can avoid this competition. Now what happens in this? Under it, output and price are fixed by different firms as a group. Okay, they talk in group and they take a collective decision that let us fix the price and output of their commodity. Now they select a leading firm. Okay, leading firm is accepted as price leader by the cartel, and that leading firm or price leader will set a price for the commodity and other firms will also accept that price. Okay, all firms in cartel accept the price set by the price leader. So basically, cartel is a formal agreement among the firms to avoid competition. In this, what happens? Few groups enter into an agreement and they form a price leader. They select a leading firm who is accepted as a price leader, and that leading firm or price leader will set a price for the commodity which will be accepted by each firm in the cartel. Okay, so formation of cartel is also a very important feature in oligopoly market. The next one is entry barriers. Okay, there are barrier to the entry of new firms. As we read in perfect competition, any firm can enter. There was freedom of entry and exit. But in oligopoly market, there are barriers to the entry of new firms. These are created largely through patent right. Okay, now if there are few firms, like we talk about auto market, we talk about BMW, Audi. So these firms have patent right. Nobody can use their name. Nobody can use their brand name. Okay, so due to this, in oligopoly market, there are entry barriers. Okay, next feature is known price competition. Now what happens in such kind of market? There is competition, but there is known price competition. Okay, see, firms tend to avoid price competition. Instead, they focus on known price competition. For example, in India, let us take the example of Coke and Pepsi. Okay, they are very branded drinks company. Okay, so they sell their Coke and Pepsi at same price. If you will go in the market, then you will get Coke and Pepsi at the same rate. So to increase its share of market, each firm adopts a policy of known price competition. They do not raise the price of their commodity, because if Coke price will be raised, then consumer will shift to Pepsi, and if Pepsi's price is raised, then consumer will shift to Coke. So instead of having price competition, what does the firm do? In order to acquire the market share, they adopt the policy of known price competition. For example, they held some sponsorship programs, okay? They gave lucrative schemes to the consumers, okay? So, in such kind of market, there is no price competition. There is no price competition, okay? So, I hope it is clear to you. Now, your homework is that you have to learn oligopoly market, okay? And you have to write in your notebook the features and the definition of oligopoly market. Along with that, you have to read all the back question answers of the chapter. Okay?